morning, we're going to start with the weekly horoscope, January 1st to January 7th, 2024. Welcome to the new calendar year. This is not a new year. We are in Capricorn. Capricorn in the zodiac is the 10th sign. Okay, so it's kind of like beginning in October, right? So, not that it's October, that sounds confusing, but I'm just saying. The new year starts when the sun goes into Aries. That's the new astrological year. So let's just keep that straight. This is the last quarter. And let's pretend life is a football game. And the football game starts with minute one, right? First quarter's down. Second quarter's down. When did the second quarter end? It ended just before Jupiter went retrograde. And guess what? Jupiter is now direct as of a day or two ago. So we're having to play catch up this whole last quarter. Our ideals, our Jupiter is expansion, positivity, it's our belief system, it's justice, it's the legal system, it's the judge. People think that Saturn is the judge. No, Saturn is Father Time. He's the structure of the realm. But Jupiter is the arbiter. And Jupiter and Taurus, he went all the way up to like 20-something degrees. Now he's at 5 degrees of Taurus, turning around. Stationary, actually. He's going to be there for a while. So I wanted to discuss this week's astrology, but also it's the first of the year. So let's talk about 2024. What are we doing? I hope you can hear this. And let's go. So I'm going to start with Libra because I'm surrounded by Libras. My moon is in Libra. And at least Libra rules my career because I'm a Capricorn rising. So it really is a strong kind of indicator of what's going on in my career and in my family. And it's just amazing how much Libra is in my life. Libras, I kind of see it as a ping pong game. They see both sides. They're very justice oriented. But because they see both sides, their brains tend to go the ping pong table, back and forth, back and forth. And it's very difficult to like make up your mind, make a decision, find out what's right for you, because you're programmed to decide what's right for everybody else. And yet you're still a human being, a heartling, an earthling. And it's important to do the right things for yourself. Libras have a real hard time doing that. And I admit that. I mean, I admit that I do, you know. And all the things, right? So I'm listening to the dark academia train. Kind of quiet background music. So let's start with Libra. Libra, the new year starts for you with an emphasis on your private life. And it could stay that way for a bit longer. It's actually a theme of the year. A little bit of coffee. In your personal life, you can be who you like to be. And if you're not in a good mood, no one will see it. Not in a good mood is indicated by Venus. She's in Sagittarius, square to Saturn. Venus and Sag will be interested in extensive contacts, but Saturn in Pisces makes it difficult or even prevents it. Saturn in Pisces can stand for health issues and indicate work that becomes too much or too stressful for you. Saturn for Libra is in Pisces, which is the sixth house, day to day, your work commute, your pets, your routines. Okay, Pisces. It loses its footing, the ground under your feet. The Capricorn Sun, in connection to Jupiter and the Moon at the beginning of the year, can balance this out. And you may feel it in your domestic and private life. There's a grand trine. What it's talking about here is with Capricorn, the Sun, in connection with Jupiter in Taurus, both Earth signs, the Moon is in Virgo at the first of the year, today, January 1st. So that's a grand Earth trine, very stable, very grounding, feels good, okay? So you may feel that in your domestic and private life. Now on January 21st, Pluto will enter Aquarius for the second time. A door is likely to open for you with momentum. Now that's your fifth house. That can be a liberating blow. So it's liberating, but it's a blow. If you withdraw too much into the domestic sphere and participate too little in public life and exciting events. In relationship love, relationships need to be nurtured. Even if it's a struggle to find the right words or make the right move. And, oh, dear Libra, love you. But the fourth house is Capricorn, and that's hard. That means home is always prickly and walking on eggshells, right? And then your opposite sign is Aries. That's fire and unpredictability. And, yes, exciting, but, you know, you got your hands full here. And so sometimes when you try to say something, it bounces right back to you. And those are poison arrows. They hurt. Now, with Saturn there in Pisces, that's your sixth house again. It's because of his high ideals. Pisces is really, they're very interested in the collective. They're very interested in other people. And they are the 12th sign, so they sort of have already been there and done that, and they understand. You have to look at this. They are consideration, responsibility for each other, supporting and helping each other. Now, if all this comes naturally to you, Saturn won't be a problem, but a promoter of committed connections. But what it doesn't say there is, what if it doesn't come naturally to you? What if you don't give other people consideration and you don't feel responsible for those in your family or the ones you love, or supporting and helping each other? That's supporting and helping each other. Okay, if there is no balance in that situation, this will be a problem. Okay, so that just means you have to figure out what your values are. What do you value, Libra? You know, do you really have love? Or are you just going through the motions because you... Habit. Which is what Pisces, that sixth house is habits. Plus, remember, Libra, the south node, which is the untangling of the knot, the gandanta, the knot, that knot, the Rahu Ketu, the nodes of the moon, is going through your sign. And it's been doing this now for a few months. It's down to the 21 degrees of Libra. It's going to go all the way to 0 degrees Libra in about a year. So during that time, as it is the inverse of all the other planets, the nodes go in reverse, kind of like a gyroscope. One goes forward, one goes backward. But this south node is for you to let go of the ego, let go of the knots and the tangles. South node in Libra. Libra, you're going to be different after this whole situation. In about a year's time, when the south node leaves, the north node leaves Aries. You've got the Aries-Libra axis. Libra, you're also an Aries. Your dark side is Aries. So, with the south node going through Libra, it's untangling all those knots. The control, the stubbornness, have to have it my way. You're going to save the world, but you want it on your terms. Yeah, that's all going to go with the south node in your sign. So, all right. Next, we're doing the cardinals. Okay, Cancer. Cancer, the moon trines the sun and Jupiter at the beginning of the year. It's also conjunct with Lilith. These constellations inspire courage and a desire for more self-will and stamina. Stationary Mercury has something important to say that doesn't fit into any box. It may slip out before you have grasped the dimensions of the words. Perhaps you can't comprehend the full extent, but at least part of it. And this Mercury to Neptune, Mercury in Sagittarius, square Neptune in Pisces, that requires humility, which is a mature achievement of Mercury in Sagittarius. Yes, Mercury is stationing direct, and that maturity, the humility, it's going to start to unpack itself. The tension between Venus in Sagittarius and Saturn in Pisces also indicates maturity if you manage to deal with contradictions and adopt a higher perspective. You're evolving, Cancer. You are raising your vibration. Have people become a little wiser and more peaceful now? It will be the case for some. Others struggle with powerlessness, can no longer bear particular images, and take refuge in distractions. It is indeed challenging to find balance and a feeling of lightheartedness. Spirituality and social commitment can help. So spirituality, developing a bit of a let go, let God kind of philosophy, whatever the good is for you. And a social commitment, meaning if, let's say, just there was some innocent bystander was hurt, you would go and help them. That's just being a member of the human race and helping those who need you if the opportunity came up. In relationship love, Venus and Mars are in the fun-loving sign of Sagittarius. But Mars reaches the end and moves into Capricorn on Thursday. And Venus has similar tensions with Saturn. Capricorn and Saturn require maturity and sensible approach to aging. That includes the foresight you have developed, which can bear fruit now that Mercury turns direct in Sagittarius. You think long term. And some even ponder beyond earthly relationships. Indeed. All right, let's go to Capricorn. Capricorn, the new year is an invitation for you to become even braver. You have already become a little troublesome, but more is to come. You may have to wait for the arrival of Mars in Capricorn on Thursday. That will boost your energy and courage. Before that, Mercury shifts into forward gear. That's tomorrow. Mercury has debunked some illusions. Now it's a matter of nurturing the wishful images worth holding on to. That is also the idea of Venus in Sagittarius, in tension with Saturn in Pisces. It is about sorting out. What is left is valuable, practical, and suitable for the future. Have you already used the holidays to clear out a bit? And what about the use of your personal space? Do you have any bold ideas for the new year? Do you have any particular travel destinations? You could envisage going to the mountains. A fitness program would also suit you as soon as Mars reaches Capricorn. Friday, for example, would be the ideal endurance training, provided you have already done a little preparation by then. Respect your limits and don't overestimate yourself. In relationship love, if you take good care of yourself, challenging planetary constellations, no problem. Venus opposes Saturn, indicating a confrontation with self-esteem, which you must nurture. That requires you to say no more often. It is also encouraged by the moon with Lilith in Virgo at the turn of the year. What seems bold to you is probably quite ordinary to other people. Sometimes you are too modest, normal, adaptable, and well-behaved. Yes, this has to stop. All right, Capricorn, let's go to Aries. Aries, Mars in the last degrees of Sagittarius can mean it is no longer worth investing in a project. Mercury turns direct and indicates a moment of insight. A new project would need more substance. Like the sign of Capricorn that Mars moves into on Thursday. This week begins with the moon in Virgo, with Lilith. How brave and unconventional can you be? On Friday, the moon moves from cautious Libra into stubborn Scorpio, and it is a challenging aspect to Pluto. It is an intense moment with a mood of farewell. Do you need to let go of something completely to start something new? Or do you need to slim down a project to make it feasible? If you are on the road, you have to expect slow-moving traffic. Nothing is going how you wanted or thought it would. With Mercury in tension with Neptune. Neptune has a tendency to fog things, by the way. Things are going differently. But at the weekend, you have a good chance of a win or a pleasant surprise. Someone says something that falls on fertile ground with you. In relationship love, Venus is in tension with Saturn, repeatedly giving you a hard time throughout the year. That is due to your high expectations, which reality can't live up to. High ideals are good if you want to reorient yourself in love and take new, better paths. That can also be a common goal. This way, you can transform a problematic task into a constructive solution and receive Saturn's blessing. Yes, when you construct something, when you take tasks and you work hard, that's where you receive, quote unquote, Saturn's blessing. All right. So that is, now let's go to Aquarius. We're going to go to the fixed signs now. We just did the cardinals, now let's do fixed. Fixed air, Aquarius. Pluto is on the cusp of Aquarius and already tickling you. You have an idea of your greatness and potential, but you still lack the courage to see this as fact. During such transitions, you can also lapse into the other extreme and feel overpowering. But it doesn't look like that right now. If it has occurred already, Mercury has already exposed it. The constellations at the turn of the year indicate that people have come down to Earth and said goodbye to exaggerated wishful thinking. But there are still a few wishes and visions left. There is a hard core you cannot throw overboard. You should nurture this seed and allow it to grow. This week, you can do this primarily in thoughts that have repercussions. With stationary Mercury in tension with Neptune, your thoughts have repercussions. Mars can't do much more at the end of the idealistic sign of Sagittarius, so there is little concrete to do. On Thursday, though, Mars moves into Capricorn and looks for something to do. But it can't just be any old job. You want to do something meaningful and valuable. In relationship love, which dream have you already realized? Perhaps you need to look back a little or look around your circle of acquaintances to find what you are looking for. You require a good example that allows you to keep dreaming, a goal you can aim for. You are somewhere between no longer and not yet. in this transition. You need patience and people with fantastic stories as role models. Here you go, Aquarius. Okay, I'm going to take a drink of coffee and restart the music. Aquarius. Okay, the next one is Leo. I'm going to do Leo. The next fixed sign, fixed fire. Leo. Wait, let me take a drink. Okay, Leo. As a rule, Leo is quite courageous. You can feel this well at the beginning of the year and show more independence. You don't have to please anyone, and you won't bend over backward for anyone either. You may find yourself in the role of a leader. That would suit Leo well. Stationary Mercury in Sagittarius is demanding. When you say something, it must be well thought out and far-sighted. If something slows you down, it is because of concerns or fears. How far can you think? How far can you go? On January 1st, the Virgo moon with Lilith demands that you make yourself socially useful with considerable courage. This task will keep you busy throughout the year. It is a year of work and service for you, Leo, but you never do it in vain. It always results in something sensible, even grand and meaningful. Jupiter is in your favor, so you don't have to worry about your effectiveness and popularity. Your motto for 2024? Courage pays off. There is an issue in your love life you are struggling with. It may be about getting older and requires patience. You hear phrases like, but you look good for your age. There's always a but in there. That is Saturn setting boundaries and forcing modesty. Saturn is honest and incorruptible. It is committed to reality, but Saturn is in the flexible sign of Pisces, so it can also blur reality. Then you are as old as you feel. All right, let's go to Taurus. For you, Taurus, the year has begun with an awareness of your well-being. Perhaps you would like to do more for your physical fitness in the future. Or you may like to relax more often and allow yourself time out. The moon is conjunct with Lilith on January 1st, which makes you want to take more care of yourself, even if your environment doesn't like it and someone is missing out. You deserve it. The more you live according to this motto, the less problematic the constellations can work. Of course, the constellations don't work at all, but merely show you what is going on. It is now your job to look after yourself. Of course, you are also eyeing other people and are happy when they notice your positive changes. However, you shouldn't peek too often, as this will also confront you with your expectations. And people will tell you if you don't achieve your goals. Always keep to yourself and have a good time. People will notice it in you. The Venus-Saturn tension is a challenge for your love life. You don't get anything for free, but if you don't expect anything, you may still get something that gives you deep pleasure. Venus in Sagittarius likes it when something seems particularly meaningful, especially valuable, or a little exotic. She loves freedom, but she needs relationships like the air she breathes. You can consider yourself lucky if you have someone who shares your enthusiasm. All right, Scorpio, fixed water. Mercury turns direct again on Tuesday. Mars leaves the sign of Sagittarius on Thursday and arrives in Capricorn. You want more clarity and will gradually get it. Due to its tension with Neptune, Mercury can think extremely expansively and recognize global connections. You may see more than is good for you. But you wouldn't be a Scorpio if you didn't want to bear it. You have a strong desire to look behind the scenes and lift veils. That can become a theme for you this year because it serves your need for fundamental justice. You will repeatedly find that many people reject your background knowledge or prefer not to have much to do with you. A few, however, are hungry for a deeper understanding of situations and enjoy your friendship all the more. Mars is moving along the path where Mercury was retrograde and must follow up insights with action. It is still too early, but you're preparing for your mission by absorbing information and imagining future scenarios. Of course, you also cultivate and perfect the subtleties that fascinate you about other people in yourself. In relationship love, what you admire in your partner is something that is also in you. Your partner can awaken it in you and will encourage it without knowing it. Of course, you offer your partner something similar or of similar value. If giving and receiving are no longer balanced, it is the end of a relationship. You constantly check whether the relationship still meets your requirements, but you are not a person who lets go too soon. A strong connection is the most important thing to you. Okay. So we're done with the fixed signs. Now let's go with the mutable. And we're going to start with Pisces. Pisces, Mercury turns direct again on Tuesday, but stays in tension with Neptune for a while. As a result, thoughts remain very expansive and wander in all directions. Is it possible to find a fixed point of view? Hardly. It is more about orienting yourself towards universal values. With Venus, Saturn in Pisces, it applies to all people, no matter where they come from and where they are going. Mars may be able to help you when it comes into Capricorn on Thursday. Mars can manifest as a male person with a strong sense of reality, responsibility, and clarity. Straightforward statements are beneficial if they fit into your broad philanthropic image. If you are the type to want to save the world, this person or life can also show you the limits of your scope of action or your powers. Because if you take on too much, you end up helping no one. You are primarily responsible for yourself, and sometimes you forget that. Remember this constantly throughout the year. In relationship love, personal responsibility is also an issue in your relationship life. As your partner wants you to do your bit in practical matters. Lilith and Virgo can be a stumbling block if you don't realize when and where there is something concrete to do. Your partner or the person closest to you will point this out. You require some time to grasp what it is really about. All right, Pisces, let's go to Sagittarius. Mercury turns direct again in the sign of Sagittarius and remains in tension with Neptune for now. The process of realization is not yet complete. Now you realize what you could have done differently in certain situations. It's never too late. Venus in Sagittarius also has to do with the time factor, with Saturn, in square to Saturn, right? And describes relationship situations that require a lot of patience. You see through the subtle devaluations. What is the aim of this? It is about controlling others and looking better yourself. When you devalue someone else, this is what you're doing. What if you have devalued yourself? Wouldn't that be self-sabotage? Can you stop doing that in the future? Venus enhances your charm and power of attraction. Saturn seems to want to prevent this, but Saturn wants you to be aware of your charisma and appeal and to use them appropriately in your interpersonal contacts. Saturn also wants more depth, commitment, reliability, and a sense of responsibility. You ought to feel how crucial the slightest incidental remarks can be. The soul is a sponge that soaks up everything. In relationship love, Venus is in tension with Saturn and describes a strong desire for a relationship with simultaneous rejection. If the desire for a connection weren't so strong, there would probably be no rejection. It looks like self-protection. Why are you trying to protect yourself? Because you're afraid of too much closeness, of being taken in by your partner, and no longer able to pursue your inclinations freely. Who is more frightened of the other? You are each other's mirror. Okay, Sagittarius. Now we have Virgo. It's the Earth mutable, and then we'll have Gemini. So here we go, Virgo. The year has started with a Moon-Lilith conjunction in Virgo in connection with the Sun and Jupiter. That is a resounding yes to life. It has also begun with stationary Mercury in tension with Neptune. You realize how little you ultimately know. That's at least something. Yes, Virgo. You can't move forward if you think you know everything already. You don't. No one does. And most wise people, the older they get, the more they know, the more they realize they don't know. So that's wisdom, is realizing you don't know. Okay, that's the something it's talking about. It started with Venus in tension with Saturn. This feels like a blemish or a ban on pleasure, and is not particularly pleasant. You take these themes with you into the new year, but there is room for development. The Sun and Jupiter describe realistic growth. Mercury and Neptune indicate the opportunity to forgive and the ability to think long-term. The emphasized Sagittarius sign shows that you are developing or have developed a higher understanding of global connections, and you're now using them. Venus-Saturn stands for the harvest. You reap what you have sown and nurtured. The emphasized element of Earth indicates you have much work to do. Mars will move into Capricorn on Thursday and make hard work a theme. With the Sun and Mars in Capricorn, you will demonstrate your efficiency as if anyone had ever doubted it, especially yourself. In relationship love, your theme for the year is self-determination. That can be difficult for your partner, but perhaps it is your partner who is pushing you towards more autonomy. Sometimes you need a counterpart whose behavior affects you. Saturn and Neptune are opposite the sign of Virgo, two very different energies, one of which is orderly and the other indicates chaos. But both also stand for charity in Pisces and are essential for you in the long term. Okay, and the last one is Gemini, last but never least. The favorable connection of the Capricorn Sun to Jupiter in Taurus and the Virgo Moon has carried over into the new year. These constellations can replace what others lack: reliability, fundamental trust, and courage. Mercury is stationary and turns direct again on Tuesday, but for the time being remains in tension with Neptune, which sweeps away all certainties. You can take this as an invitation to trust and draw new hope. If you are spiritual, this is relatively easy. Materialists and realists have a more challenging time. The moon is conjunct with Lilith, an invitation to become more brave and care less about what others think. In addition, the moon-Lilith conjunction in the sign of Virgo has health topics on the agenda, with alternative healing methods offering a great opportunity. It will do you good to leave your usual ways of thinking and try gentler, more subtle remedies. In interpersonal relationships, forgiveness would be the mellow healing path. In relationship love, Gemini, Mercury's change of direction in a tense aspect with Neptune and Venus in tension with Saturn paint the picture of a great game of patience. Neptune and Saturn appear fateful, and there's nothing you can do. Venus and Mars in Sagittarius stand for a thirst for adventure and joy at something potentially meaningful. You can sense the meaning by looking as far as possible beyond all earthly boundaries. Okay, now let's read the general. The new year has begun, and with an almost exact Moon-Jupiter connection, which has diffused the tensions between the Moon, Venus, and Saturn. This constellation gives you confidence in your strength and outstanding courage, which you experience on January 1st either as something joyful and lively or as something threatening or monstrous, in which case it's not your courage. Mercury is stationary and goes direct again on Tuesday in tension with Neptune. Anyone recognizing their part in a problematic situation can give in and ask for forgiveness. Reconciliation is the order of the day. Isn't that outrageous? Some people seem irritated when something steps out of right and wrong and shakes hands. Right and wrong are so beautifully simple. The nuances are much more challenging to deal with. If you are searching for clarity, you'll be pleased to hear that Mars moves into Capricorn on Thursday. However, its ruler Saturn will still be in Pisces for a long time and will keep questioning your point of view. We live in a time of great upheaval, so it is advisable never to commit yourself too early or to think you have everything figured out. Pluto moves into Aquarius, I believe the 20th of January, so we've got a ways to go. Relationship love, this is the general. Venus in tension with Saturn indicates ideals you struggle with. Venus seeks variety and adventure. Saturn seeks security, which it finds in the social or family network. Saturn also describes difficult conditions under which love cannot develop well, unless it is impersonal and relates to all humanity or the whole world. Saturn can also indicate a gradual parting if a relationship has outlived its usefulness. Okay, that is the end of the weekly horoscope. Thank you for your time and attention, and we'll see you next week. Bye-bye.